Today, we will elevate on the topic work. Basically, regarding September 23rd and let's say September 28th, as in these wave predictions and wave X and planet X and this X and this. For years and years and years, we'll be hearing predictions. First of all, what I say to predictions is stop. If you're not Nostradamus, and you're not cryptic enough, and you don't have the sight like the masters have in the past, stop predicting. Also, I'd have to say, yes, it might hurt a few people, and it will, burn your beak. But this is, I feel the universe wants to communicate that through me, so I'm streaming that right now, as I feel that is what needs to be corrected, needs to be shared. Right now, you can say the infestation or the disagreeable, or the parasitic energy, or whatever you want to call them, archons, reptilians, fallen Nephilim, Anunnakians, Draconians, whatever the label is of what you will call the unwanted energy, is trying everything they can to make you go nuts. So understand, the war is not so much outside. Everybody looks at MIB, the government, CIA, Obama, and you have it. All of this right now, we need to cut all the BS right now, because understand, the mind is a bullshit artist. Why? Because when the mind is bored, it concocts a lot of elusive situations and scenarios that will create an emotional response that will only do what? Feed the parasitic environment. If you watch something or a show that you don't like, and you watch the show over and over and you complain, well, you're contributing to the problem. If you watch something that you like and you support that, you're contributing to the solution. So question is, what we have to ask ourselves, and that is the message for September 23rd to the 28th, as in the energy wave, is as a conscious wave. First of all, I do not resonate with the fact that the fear propagation of there's a wave coming and it's going to wipe out the unworthy, and those who are worthy will make it, or the entire planet is going to be wiped out. If Earth would have been wiped out, guess what? I wouldn't be talking. YouTube wouldn't exist. The human race would be extinct. Okay? Also, when in ET contact, know this. If you're talking to a civilization that is, and I'm putting it mildly, only 50,000 years ahead of your time, what is it that we have on Earth that they need to accelerate them? Zero. We just have to be rational here and realistic. Also, the insanity is like, if somebody can show that they have a system that works, and the old paradigm says, well, but you have no scientific evidence. Well, if a guy has a machine that runs and he can show it to everybody and he can replicate it and build it, and you have 15 people that are actually have a system that works for them, I don't need a patent. I don't need scientific evidence. I have a system that works. So we're leaving the old paradigm. And those who don't understand it, I say, get over it, because you're not going to win. There is no more winning with the false hood of things when people bring forth stuff. Tesla did it and he was laughed at. Tesla created inventions and turned them on. People say, I can't believe what I'm seeing, or this is impossible. But nevertheless, if your schematic is correct and your plans are correct, whatever you have will work. I'm not a Bible true whatever, or Quran or Torah or Bhagavad Gita or all of these books. All of those, in their time, in their purpose, make sense when read right, when interpreted right, when actually actively integrated and practiced right. So I'll use what my grandma used to say, practice what you preach. If you don't practice what you preach, you are just like the other side, the other paradigm. And I don't care if it's MIB, surveillance, and this and that, and spies, and all of the stuff that does not pay your bills. No Anunnakians, no reptilians right now are doing a paint job on my car or fixing my tire when it's flat. Nor does a prayer will heal me when my healing doesn't take place. And that's another topic that I wanted to share. This is about reality check. And this is how I see it. And I've learned a lot as I'm healing myself, going through stuff that I learned in my mind where I realize this is utter nonsense. There's nothing even happening. So I spoke to a lady a while ago, at a place, and she had problems with metals, wearing different metals, metallurgy. So I saw, to my observation, you know, and you can shoot me when I'm wrong, and I have a proof that I'm not. That's coming up. I said that that's what I see and sense, and that's where telepathy begins. What is within her that has this mechanism going of the biomechanical failures that we have. And a lot of people on this planet don't die of natural causes. Over, and that's the hidden statistic, over 90% on this planet die of biomechanical failure. Also understand, a synthesis of a product, as in medicine, that is synthetic. How in your right mind can you think you can heal a biological organism that needs biodegradable material to inspire to heal itself, because it can and it always did? In the ancient times we did it, now we don't. So we need to come back to reality. You have a healer, you have an ulcer, and you have a healer. And after 4 years, I'm asking you, so how is the proceedings with your healing? The same thing with the lady that has this is being allergic to different metals. Well, she's still allergic. The other lady still has an ulcer. This guy still has lupus. You still carrying your Lyme. Oh, even the Rife machine only worked this much. And you still have something dormant that keeps coming back. So what's the reality of the matter? And that is where I want to talk about actual facts. Talk to a lady that had cancer. Said her x-rays showed in the back, you know, in Germany they call it metastase. I don't know if that, but what is that called in English? It's like a network of a cancerous growth that was clearly visible in the x-ray. So now I want to know, because that lady healed herself and certified has x-rays that show she is clear of that growth. It's no longer in her body. That to me is physical fact. Not whether it is the theoretical healer or the rhetoric that's been talked or your health insurance that you pay for 20 years. And like my mom going to the doctor to get treatment for her back pain, and over 27 years, her back pain is unaltered and unchanged. And I'm asking myself, what's missing here? What's the reality? When does healing effectively take place? And I don't know if I want to mix that with this video. I want to also interview a guy that has something to say about that. So one basic level here for me is that we have to understand right now, darkness smacks you with all of the stuff they have and goes crazy with all of the stuff that they have, which brings me to the ultimate fact is, what's going to happen September 23rd? Guess what? Nothing much, but you realizing yourself and more illusions leaving you. The sun will go up, it'll be another day, and maybe next year there's going to be another prediction of another event taking place. I believe in positive events taking place. I do not believe in the hoaxed alien abduction, fake government approach that everything is so hideous. If I'm a race and I'm from a million years ahead of your time, I am not vicious, I'm not violent, because it's not no longer in my consciousness. Can you understand there are races out there that they don't understand war? They would land here, guess what? They would be killed. Because that is the mind state and part of the old paradigm that is resisting the, how do you say, the evolution of where consciousness is going. Remember when Darth Vader said something, coming from the dark side, it is useless to resist. So, I'm saying that for the light. Surrender to the energy that is there, the peace that exists within, the clarity that you have. And you don't need to follow a trend just because it is in to be esoteric. I read about metaphysics since I was 11 because I was inspired. Not that it was a trend, not because it's called starseed, or I figured out through the course of my life that I'm Arcturian and it's hard to be Pleiadian or Arcturian or Sirian or Zeta Reticulin, and then the race wars begin all over. If it's not black people, then it's Mexicans. If it's not Mexicans, see, in Germany now we have Syrian refugees, it's the Syrians. And if it's another person that needs help, we always want to pin it on some race, and that goes back to the Anunnakian times. That's how far back that goes. All of that distraction is needed to drive you away from understanding that you have to come back to center, get out of color. Yes, we know from what supremacy system we come from when we've been through in 400 years of this and this and this and that, but right now, not. Right now, I'm not in Africa. Right now, I'm in Sedona, Arizona. Right now, actual fact is I'm an 8th Apache, which is Diné, Navajo derivative. I'm part German. I'm part American. And somewhere down the line, my ancestors came from Africa. But I don't feel that I have to go to the motherland because there's another trend, or that I have to celebrate anything that. And I have a lot of African friends from Nigeria. If Nairobi, Zaire, Congo. And you know what? I love these people for being a soul in a vessel and not for their point of origin genetically on this planet. We have to expand and let go of all of this. And when we come to this, we understand we have to feel each other and come together. So I say, let's predict nothing for September 23rd to the September 28th, like a gigantic wave is going to come. Usually the shaman felt when something would move or was time to move, the shaman moved. Well, I was moved by my interdimensional contact to Sedona to see a lot of things, to clear a lot of illusions, and to heal that and create that, what I'm creating and setting that up without, how do you say, emotional fire. So don't think that I'm mad because this sounds forceful. This is just that right now the energy wants to communicate that is what is important in your life is follow your passion. Enjoy. Don't live the lie. Clear yourself, really cleanse yourself. And I'm talking about cleansing, not by 100 million supplements. And I maybe turn this into a second video. Get into organic sulfur. Check the Health Revolution with interview Patrick McGeehan, McGeehan. Listen to this, where there's people that have cleared 500,000 clients. They have no commercial ads out. People that had chemo, lupus, Lyme, all types of diseases, not one complaint of the product, not one return. It's not Apple, it's not commercial, it's not all the way out there. Not that I'm dissing Apple, I love it. Not that I'm dissing PC, I grew up on Apple, put it this way. But anyway, if you have a modality that can help, and that's just for your own observation, that can help 500,000 people, and you have no commercial funding, and nobody's really behind you, and you can't say healing, you have to say wellness, because everything is attacking, well, then I have to look at the picture and say, well, okay, there's something wrong here. We have people that can help people, we can help each other, but we're very quick, and I look at it, it's called the Jesus principle, that everybody wants to prosecute, everybody wants to crucify. Oh, there's a guy, and everybody does it, and I mean, if you want to go back to the famous Jesus, because everybody says that the second coming, Jesus, he's us. Comes from the ancient Sumerian word Iyasu, Yeshua, those of the knowledge, of the knowing who they are, with the memories that you own of your cosmic, and see how they all in the back responding, now, right now, it's getting louder because they're responding to the energy that wants to communicate, and the spirits of, you can say, the insects that you hear behind in the trees, the chiquetas, are assisting me in that. They want you to hear and understand. See this? See how this works? Every time I do this, this works. The entire morning it was quiet, and I'm beginning to share something. The wind blows, sky moves, things happen. So there's something that wishes to communicate. Now I'm just a particle of your consciousness reflecting back to you. This is what we're going through. Don't fall for the illusion. I don't feel that that we have to believe there's ET contact that's gonna abduct us and take over the planet. If I'm coming from a million years in the future, and I know I'm jumping here and there, but that's how I function. If I'm a million years ahead with my technology, I can unexist your planet in a nanosecond if I wanted to. Who is the one that always implements war? Guess what? Our primate state of Reese's DNA connection always needs this leader structure, following structure, overpowering, and warmongering. It's part of an Anunnaki and ancient programming of a reptilian survival code. And if we can catch that code and overcome that code, we can live much better lives. And when telepathy is reestablished, telepathy, mate, and the telepathic links and the ley lines between the villages are reestablished, wars will end. Science has proven that. Check Dan Winter, check the things that people refer to, David Wilcock, Guyam TV. There are people that literally saw it bust their ass, and I don't care what color you are, you know. I know in the metropolitan area we have critical things, we have problems with the law, with the enforcement, how it is enforced. I suggest if you're in an area that is with a conflict, retreat from the conflict, don't contribute to the conflict, and make something that is different. So I'm not going to any demonstration or any revolution or anything that is violent of any nature. I'll sit in my lab, I do my work, I put my keys together, I paint my pictures, and I share with the people what I think they need to hear, which is beneficial. So I think that we are surrounded by an industrial complex of an ET civilization, and Earth is under quarantine because right now the motto of this ascension protocol is basically get your shit together. Get it right. Stop following the trend or be a trend follower. A lot of people even talk about they claim contacts, they're not contactees, they have never seen anything, they never had interdimensional contact, but yet they claim. How do we know this? Because people can imagine things, and when you get into the resonant field and you learn how to feel people, and you get into their resonance, you see if you're not getting goosebumps, well, where's the truth that validates that person really has lived that and emotionally been there and been in contact? And as you see, this work is hard. You get no trophies, you get no Oscars, there's no, hey, yeah, you did it. It takes years and years and years for people to find, what does this guy do? What's the progress? And what makes sense for me? So I'm saying, if you want the bullies out of your life, astral entities and attachments, genuine contact, clear telepathic communication, clear your vessel first. And over 90% on this earth are infested, and the war is not outside, the war is inside. We have viral activity in our bodies that shows our brain, or basically entrains our brain into a domesticated war pet, and we react this way. I see it online, and it's sad that Facebook is so infested with people, everybody has something to say or attack somebody. I've seen that lately with channelers being attacked, that people say, oh, you're channeling demons, this can't be right. People that genuinely actually help, you know, and then they bring all types of titles and designs and beings that are created and fabricated from the mind. That just guy one utters it, he has an impact, and then everybody runs and follows. It's the Archons, it's the Archons. You don't know what that is. You don't know what that is based on. There's no physical evidence that this exists in this realm. All I see the physical evidence is in life. That is, if you do bad, bad unfolds. If you make a bad choice, the sum of bad choices will, guess what, will lead to a collapse that will show you that your universe is an illusion, as in you're not creational, you're not co-creating, you're not building, you're not working together. But what I see is when there are people out there that have a forum, they're being supported. When I'm looking at my forum, I'm very hard, very critical, and I'm very proud of the people that with me on Facebook that keep it clean, that do not curse, they do not go derogatory and attack people for no reason. That is the discipline that is required for you to clear your vessel, clear your mind, and clear everything on all levels. Like, again, if you really want to clear yourself, and trust me, when you get into this organic sulfur, and then after the fourth day, you think you're going through hell. You think you want to call the doctor or the ambulance. Guess what? Now you're really detoxing. Now you're really getting into a structure where what does your body actually need? The lack of oxygen is fear. The lack of oxygen is pain. So how many out there that watched that have ever had pain or fear in their life? Probably all of you. But how this can be beat? That we can actually create a fearless society that clearly can see what we're doing to each other, and it needs to end and it needs to stop. And some of us, yes, we are policing this, as in we're watching this, we're evaluating, and we remember, and we will document what's happening to us. And I did that with rappers growing up with hip-hop. If you came across me as an MC, yeah, and this, and I've been on stage, and this and that, I would, and this is just a metaphor, so don't take it personal, I would say, okay, let's battle. Let's do a freestyle battle on stage. 95% fell apart on stage or didn't even make it to the stage, didn't even come up on stage. I had 6,000 people in front of me and said, I'm ready because I'm trained, I practice this, this is my craft. Same thing with the esoteric aspect that I'm doing. I study every day. I learn every day. I take this very, very to heart because this is our life. This is my life. And you know what? The most important thing is why things work and can work. And that's not based on Hollywood and how your funding goes and how rich or poor you are. Is the universe is asking you basically, do you care? Do you genuinely care about the things? And what are you going to do if you're being treated unfair? You're going to linger there? You know, I've seen places where people created potlucks and exclusively you're invited and it's $70. Where I come from, camping, campfire, you don't pay. If you have something, you want to bring some bread or something or whatever you want to eat, you're free to do whatever. I provide, I set it up, you don't pay. If I'm in trouble, I'm not using a cloaked metaphor of a meeting of people coming together to pay my bills or to pay my mortgage. I say, listen, I have problems with my mortgage payments. I'm not trying to lose this here. My calculation went wrong. In all honesty, basically, I'm stripping myself naked. Can anyone help me? That will be honest. But not saying it's green and it's potluck, and I've seen it in many that goes from Sedona out to many places. Is I have people that I knew, street kids, that kept it realer than those who run around in white wands, do this all the time, and it's namaste, and when you really, really need them, where are they? This is from experience. They're gone. Nobody has your back. The true ones that are here, that are consistent, and that are with you, and they don't fear the truth. And this is always that what hurts. The fear when truth and knowledge is being shared, that you want to run away. But every time I realize if somebody is not willing or ready to process something that seeks clearance, they walk away. They say this discussion ends here, or they don't approach you anymore, or they find means to not be in contact because they can't face the conflict and they can't handle it, which is okay. But what I wish for in the forum, the trolling, here's the thing, is like this. The level of infestation to me has to do with the viral activity in the body and how people act out their viral collective. The wars has to do with the more you infest it, the more you're warmongering. The more your body is corrupt, guess what? The more your actions will be corrupt. The more discipline you have to be divine, even though if you have a viral infection, see, as we talk, I'm beating Lyme disease, but that doesn't have to turn me into an a-hole. And I don't have to be corrupt. I'm learning more to look into this, how we got beat. I had a tick bite when I was little, and I realized it was dormant for many, many years, and it was a limiter. And now we're taking that limiter out of the system, out of the equation. No more fear. I'm treating myself with, yes, organic sulfur and automatic immune system cell programming to really understand what is this vessel actually made of. And I'm learning a whole lot. I will also, according to that, develop a healing program, or put it in better perspective, a wellness program that I will call the Ra Food Diet. And in detail, I will enlist what actually effectively has worked for over 500,000 people in combination, how to eat right and how to eat correct, to get your senses together. Because right now we have to make sense. This nonsense has to end. And when we see it, it's like whenever you catch somebody online that has to drop a negative vote because they hate somebody, level of infection. Whenever somebody has something negative to say or attack you or go derogative, that's your viral infection acting out and they're running you. You're not in control. Whenever, and that's the divine side, you are watching a video that you like, you for that video, you're promoting and you're sustaining and help sustain people that are actually consistent in what they promote, you have more discipline over your body than those that are infected. Yes, they'll be forgiven, but the actions are not forgotten. So don't sleep And also be aware, these predators are looking out for these non-resistant spiritual communities that say, come into my house, take my stuff, eat my food, take everything from me. I don't defend myself because I'm this poor living individual. You're not poor, you're not broke, you are resilient and you are resistant, as your immune system is alert and aware. So the best defense, whether it's psychic, astrally, or whatever you do, is have awareness of yourself, your inner environment, your inner verse, and then your surrounding environment. That is a reflection of the viral infection that so much was based on the protection of the complexion. Understand the selection with affection. Understand what I've just told you. We have to unsolve that riddle, get out of this, get clear, and heal ourselves. When I see a forum or a network online in the social media where nobody trolls, nobody curses, nobody gets political, and everybody contributes to something that enables people to do and create and live and expand, we're clear. If I see all the other behavior, that means learning is still to do. And I'm not the master, the guru, or whatever. I'm just allowing myself, like a seer, to see things that I'm allowing myself, repeating myself here, to share with you. This is the perception. And I'm asking the individual, can we make a difference with a different choice? Saying, like, if I don't eat in a certain restaurant because I don't like the food, does that mean I have to set that restaurant on fire, curse out the cook, toss the plates around, and flip out? Or can I be disciplined enough to say, I prefer the Chinese restaurant, and I go there, and I promote that, and I eat there, and that's that. So what I do online, as for my discipline, I will not give a negative vote. I give a positive vote, or I stay neutral. I'm trying my best to not go in a way where I'm like, what the heck am I doing? Or promote to whatever, or be reactive. Just like in Kung Fu, we know when you have an emotional reaction to an attack, guess what? The karma wheel is spinning and the opponent actually can mess you up because you're all derailed, because you're out of your center and you're emotional. The trick is now to be not emotional, to integrate that, to breathe, sit with it, look at it, and then say, why am I responding negative to the situation? What is that that triggers that in me that I feel that I have to respond in uproar? It is my storyline only. And as they say, in the universal law, what's yours is yours, what's mine is mine. And the conflict comes when the ego thinks it can imagine that you can mix that, because that is an illusion. That is a non sequitur, that doesn't take place, it doesn't happen, only in your mind. So if you want to flip out, or get guns, or go crazy, or get violent, because I've seen it all, that is your storyline and your responsibility to bring that to a good ending and to a good outcome. And this is what everybody's actually trying to running from, or where a lot of people are scared. We have to face the responsibility and responsible interaction and response between and among human beings. And when we have established that, we're ready to be intergalactic for other civilizations. Because we are being watched very carefully, like you have, so I have to say, like monkeys in the prison. We give them YouTube, we give them this, let's see how they create their communities, you know? Oh, they got a video here where somebody sits in a toilet and sings songs about how they're dropping it, and you have 200 million views. Oh, here's a video about somebody who has a healing modality where people can get better, 12,000 views. Oh, that's the level of consciousness where you are, so I'll stay back in retreat and observe where you are. And when, and just like in Star Trek, the movie, they said, they showed that the first time, the Star Trek movie Contact, before the Vulcan, the first, you can say, ET race, to make contact with the humans. Understand, these are all prophetic videos. They checked, the minute we have developed a device that's faster than the speed of light, contact is established. Now, why is that so important? The minute your consciousness, it's a metaphor, it's not just all spaceships and travel and this and that. The minute your consciousness can compute faster internally in it, your own neural network, faster than the speed of light, then you're ready for contact. What are we bringing in. The first segment was pretty steamy, but don't take offense. This is just a reflection of what's going on, and energy is being reflected back to what's going on now to the positive aspect is systems are now protecting themselves. You see, YouTube has a standing that records actually your behavior, as in respecting the copyright, how you talk, and these forums, whether it's Facebook or any other social media, have like an immune system. Like the people that are in their divine purpose will respond to a viral activity and will defend themselves. Hence, you will be, how you say, unfollowed or deleted or blocked if whatever your output is promoting is an upset to people. So to always bring it back to the energy wave of September 23rd till the 28th and the gamma wave X, and gamma is going to erase all life, or maybe the highest light can give you the highest conclusion to the highest perception of the highest awareness that is possible. And yes, that'll kill the old paradigm. Yes, it always will and must kill viral activity, because it's not supposed to be in a healthy organism. So if you have parasitic behavior that is antisocial and separating things and taking organisms apart and killing the hosts, well, then you have to think about what's right for you and what works for you and what do you harmonize with. So I say the intelligence that is required here is to keep the peace, to create that when our kids grow up, they don't know what war is. Maybe there won't be even any bad history anymore to remind them, this is what happened when your grandfather, you know, and we are born in sin, you know. So this living in fear and under a shadow of that you did wrong, that we can actually grow out of that and really take the kiddie pants off and mature into, we don't have to lie to each other, steal and take and rob from each other. Well, everybody talks this, the government and this and that. Well, it's the people mimicking everything else the big ones are doing. Pointing the finger, sitting there with their bad leg, not healing, politicking on television that has brainwashed us by telling lies in vision, where the news came from the library where the lies are buried. You have to understand the words that surround you and how they make sense and how they influence you when you follow the falsity of things. And by false, I mean, if somebody says, oh, put this in your tank and you'll save 60%, and you fill it in your tank and you look at your tank and you say, well, I don't even have 0.5% of savings. That is the truth. It's just an example. Somebody says, well, do this, and all of a sudden, oh, I have 42% savings and my car runs better and everything is cool and I have actually proof. That proof doesn't require nobody to say, do you have no scientific evidence? I say that's my favorite quote. I'm like, there's no scientific evidence. Well, if you talk quackademics or you come from the Howard Hall of quackademe, it might not make sense because you're trapped in your quacky little, you can say, protocol box that doesn't allow you to explore and make a different experience. We're now outgrowing that concept. So September 23rd and all of this stuff is like, no fear, no prediction. It's going to be a day like any other day. But in this month here, throughout September to towards the end of this year, the theme is get your shit together. Basically, have your business in integrity, deliver on point, be of assistance, be nice to each other, and most of all, communicate in a nice way. No more flip shows. No more using examples of others that seem to be, you put them on a pedestal because you think you're this small. You're actually very big. you're actually a very powerful being. You can make changes. And to demythify and debunk a lot of stuff, and magic is real, astral entities are real, etherical entities are real, quantum physics is as real as it gets and is infinite. But here's this. The royal power that you possess in a human vessel is you make the physical call here. If you want to get something physical or create something physical, that is your first right to create that and put it in place. And nobody can debate or debunk that. So no ghost, no Kuan Yin, no Saint-Germain, or all the other masters have any physical rulership in this dimension to do anything on this planet but inspire from the upper realms. That rule can never be broken. Otherwise, you would see them walk around, stuff flying, and in this, what we have is psychic wars and internal wars with nothing but ourselves. And if we come to the conclusion that it's only the storyline surrounding ourselves and the level of viral infection that we carry, the way we process our stuff, that is the topic we should be focused on. And when we come to clarity and clean our vessels and make ourselves holy, and I'm not basing that on any church propagation, holy, by that I mean holistically, by that I mean complete, complete as in golden. When somebody says golden, that's another word for completion. Golden, that is golden. The fractal of the element gold is a beautiful fractal, and it's the complete fractal. They say that is the most complete fractal you can find in the universe, is the gold fractal. We have to get into this. Crystals, gold, and water, that is, in the golden means, fractalized to a point that we can actually restructure this here and come to our senses. And when that takes place, and we all talk about fusion, see, we have this big hadron collider. And just ask yourself, not being a scientist, why is it that you need to smash particles, that you need to destroy in order to find God? Can we not find God by unifying and not separating and smashing? It's like you have two cars going, I don't know, 360,000 miles per hour. You smash the two cars, and then you want to figure out who the manufacturer is? You honestly think that you're going to find anything through destruction, but destruction. I want to believe, let's build a unifier. Something that brings things together, that doesn't smash things to find out, oh, did that hurt you, that I smashed you? Oh, how long does it take to heal? Well, how many times do we have to smash each other and hurt each other until we understand it takes time to heal, it is not a healthy thing to do, and after a while, you're basically killing it. Can we just not live it up, live it up, unify, bring together, elevate, make stronger? Two people sharing two ideas, each carrying one, walk away with two ideas. If you bring it to the material level, two people sharing an apple, each one walks away with half. There are systems and principles in the universe that are being applied that we have to learn how they function. And when universal lore, not in man-made law, is reintroduced to mankind, and we understand what we basically wiped out with all the tribes that we done killed all over the planet, you know? World War I, World War II, over 200 million vessels destroyed just to propagate willpower and dominion. We have to understand it has to stop. It has to end. That doing in viral infection, obsession, possession, whatever you want to call it, possession is, see, here they go again. I went to the other side of the house. It was quiet. Now you hear it again. Is nature responds to your action. And nature can only support what you do. Nature, by nature, cannot support you polluting the rivers with poison. Because you're killing their defense system. But people that think it's all about money and that at the end of the days they can eat money, well, guess what, where they will end up? They will starve. And it'll be evident. Masks will come off, people will reveal themselves, people will lose their mind, the Hopi have predicted it. The natives, my forefathers, Apache, as in Dene, as in a Navajo tribe, a Navajo nation. They all, in the ancients, when you look at things in oral tradition that has been that have been translated, everything will be revealed for what is. If somebody says something that it is not, it will never take place. So if they, you hear them talk about an alien invasion and the planet's going to be taken over, and you see Hollywood propagating these movies of all of these infiltrations, well, it never takes place. Why is that? Because it's not real. But then you have other cases that are not so much promoted that really take place, and it's the subtle. So I suggest for September 23rd till September 28th, in your life, get clear, look at how you feel, see how you're cleansing, see how the divine ones, the little ones, so-called, for me they are giants, get beat and smashed and attacked for doing their job. I honor people like Giorgio Tsoukalos, David Wilcock, Art Bell, I mean, you name them, whatever you want to call them, that come out and say they have a different experience other than that is promoted on television. Receive threats, being attacked, you know, left and right, doing their work, wanting to bring people together, helping and assisting for bringing a better future and a common medium for all to communicate on a higher and better spectrum. I honor those and I bow. Dr. Stephen Greer, 30 years, you know. You don't have to, you know, why would one come with a UFO case or contacts or bring all of this forth when you have a regular life, you have a six-figure job, and then you quit that job just to be ridiculed and attacked? When you have to look at that spectrum. The sacrifice that people have made. People lost their wives or their partners because the partner thinks, okay, now you're off the deep end. You're all crazy, you're all cuckoo. Promote each other. If even in relationships, if one partner is metaphysical, the other, open up to the fact that there's more out there and people have other perceptions. And little kids tell us what they see. Listen to their stories. Don't think it's a fantasy. There is valid storyline behind what these kids promote. Find on YouTube The Boy Who Lived Before. Little guy, 4 years old, talks about his past life in detail, and they found that past life also. So that it is real. So I say, for faith, paranormal is the new normal. Accept it, surrender to love, be wise, be aware. Don't let people take your milk money, but don't run around like you're non-resistant and everybody can mess with you. You have a right to speak up, and you have a right to say, this in my eyes is wrong. This in my eyes is right. Keep it clear in your Facebook forums. Stop the trolling. Be peaceful with each other and give each other in exchange respectfully for what's being delivered, and promote that and uplift that so everybody can live a greater day for a greater tomorrow. And that earth is already here. Earth is not neurotic. The human race needs to clear up their neurosis and their little possessions and obsessions with weird things that are derogatory, that are off-scale, uncentered, and nothing but distraction to lead you away from the center. And in the center where God is, guess what? There's you. And that's where you understand that we are all one. And when we make decisions in unison, we sing the same sound. When everybody sings the same song without being dogmatic, you will see the change. And more of you get together. My people that have been with me, I love you very much. I'm very direct and I'm very frank. You know, I thank you for sticking with me and seeing the progress. And there's more fantastic news coming. I want to do an interview with a guy who has found something very phenomenal that is not propagated, but there's 500,000 people behind it. It has to do with your healing. It has to do with organic sulfur. So study that. On that note, I catch you as usual, this time on the mega flip side. So have your business tight, you know. Have your ducks in a row, stick to your parameters, don't engage in war, don't have any emotional reactions, stay centered, and be the supreme being that you are, sovereign within the self. Be like water, my friend. Be like water.